While I love making and watching these unpopular opinion videos, I've noticed that in a lot of them there are similar opinions. So today I'm going to be discussing common opinions and how I stand on them. Number 1. Momoland are problematic. I can understand why you'd think so, but they aren't any less problematic than any other K-pop group. Yeah, they've done their fair share of dumb stuff, like Nancy making light of bulimia, but the stuff y'all hate them for is dumb. They aren't problematic for having two songs that sound the same. They aren't problematic because Nancy has a RBF. They aren't problematic because Nancy didn't smile at Blackpink. They aren't problematic because they didn't bow at BTS. Some of y'all nitpick at everything Momoland do and it's annoying. If you don't like them though, that's okay, no one is forcing you to like them, but being respectful towards them is all I'm asking of you. Number 2. Red Velvet have no stage presence. Now this one I can kind of agree on. I think they don't have stage presence for the songs they don't like. It's obvious none of them like Power Up, so they aren't going to be overly energetic while singing and dancing to it. They also don't seem to like Rookie, Irene especially, so they haven't been as energetic there, but they all seem to love RBB, so they're very energetic during that. Same with Bad Boy and Peekaboo. I would love if they were always energetic, but it's okay that they aren't. Nonetheless, even if they don't have the world's best stage presence doesn't mean they don't have any, at least to me. Number 3. Jennie is lazy. I'm tired of everyone saying this. At first it was just people saying she needed to pick up the slack, but now it's gotten to the point that that's all people say about her. Stop focusing on the bad things that she's done and give her credit for improving this era. She's done so much better and I'm happy about that. We also don't know if she's overworked to the brink of exhaustion to where she can barely work. We just don't know what's going on behind closed doors and I don't wanna judge her for stuff in the past too. Number 4. I don't like DNA by BTS. I understand this. I'm not a huge fan of it either. Not because it sounds too Western. I just don't really like EDM sounding songs and this had a lot of EDM in it. It is what got them even more success though, especially overseas, but I don't think it made them westernized. I think they were also just experimenting their sound, which is completely okay. Number 5. Stan Luna is annoying. Personally, this is what got me to Stan Luna. I wanted to see what the fuss was about and even if it was low-key annoying at first, it does gets people into Luna, which thus helps make them more popular. So even if it may be annoying, it worked for me and worked for many people too. Number 6. Shipping is dumb. Yes, it is. It's creepy as hell if when Hoseok and Yoongi post a picture together and everyone in the comments are talking about how they're dating or having sex, it's just so weird. I don't care if you ship as a bromance, but if you literally think two band members are dating, you're delusional. And don't even get me started on Jungkook and Lisa shippers. Number 7. I don't like Dala Dala, though I agreed at first. I ended up liking this song. It was definitely a song that needed to grow on me, but now I love it and can't seem to go a day without listening to it. I understand if you don't like it though. It is a little messy, but don't not listen to ITZY's next comeback because you weren't a fan of this song. Keep in mind this is just the debut. I'm sure the next will be amazing. Number 8. BTS didn't pave the way for K-pop. To be honest, I don't care who you think paved the way. To me, it depends on who you are, whatever got you into K-pop. Whether it be BTS, Girls' Generation, hell even Psy, that's who paved the way for you. I agree BTS made K-pop a little more popular and mainstream. So if you consider that paving the way, then cool. But if GG got you into K-pop, then I'm totally all for you saying they paved the way. So that's all I'm going to be talking about. Obviously there are more, but these are the main ones I have strong opinions about. Leave a comment below if you agree or disagree with how I feel. And keep streaming Number 1 by CLC on Spotify.